is adding HTML content. So I won't be diving exactly into React first of all, because I want you guys to be start off with a point from where you're already familiar with. So most React tutorials start off with start writing components and React-based concepts that might not be very familiar with people coming from HTML and CSS. Let me just start off with that, and then I'll move on to React concepts. So hopefully the starting of this session should look very familiar to you. What we have here is components. So what components is, if we look at a website, say one of our favorite websites is YouTube.com. So React uses a modern way of developing web applications, which is the component-based architecture. What component-based architecture tells you is you can build reusable components, and basically you break your site down into various things that you can reuse again. So let's say if you look at the YouTube application, you can see that all these videos are very similar. All of them have a title, all of them have a description, some link, a thumbnail, and some options, a button here. All of them look very similar. Now, it's very unlikely that some engineer in YouTube wrote all of these separately, right? It's not possible. So what they did is they wrote one component that can take variable values and can render a part of HTML depending on what values you give it. So this is exactly what we do in React, and the components are a heavy focus. Talking of React, it has the most market share in the world, almost 24%, so a large part of the world's website are built using this framework that we're learning today. Now I'll start with decoding and stop talking. So now our starting point is app.js. So I'll tell you how this page is coming from. What it does is, I showed you the root element, that one line in the HTML code. So it will get that element, and inside it, it will render our app component. The syntax you're seeing is JSX syntax. This is compiled using Babel. So to take that element, it will render using the React DOM, it will render the app component. Where's the app component coming from? App component is coming from app.js. Now inside app.js, we have these simple HTML things written. So let's change that. What we'll be learning today is how to build a Pokédex application. For those of you who watched Pokémon, you might be familiar with what that is. So basically just a simple application that lists various Pokemons. Let's get started with first of all the HTML content. Let's first delete all this we have. We won't be needing any of this. And let's start building our application. Let's say, and I'll also run the application side by side on my browser so you guys can see in real time what exactly I'm writing. Let's first make a title bars. This is just a comment, nothing fancy here. These curly brackets you see, whenever you see this kind of syntax, when you use the JSX syntax that is using these brackets, basically you're specifying HTML elements directly in JavaScript code. This is JSX syntax, and inside JSX, if you need to use JavaScript, then you use these curly brackets. This is the first difference to notice between React and regular HTML. In regular HTML, when you specify a class, you'll write class, but that won't work in React. You'll have to write class name. See, it's visible on the browser now. So now the title bar is done. Let's try to create a Pokemon card in a container, because I'll be having a list of cards. We'll start off with one card and then we will add multiple. For images, I'll be using an API. Yes, API is this sort of. Let's give this guy a name. So the Pokemon API we'll be using. Can tell us a lot of things about a Pokemon. It can tell us the ID, it can tell us the type, its techniques, abilities, a lot of things. So we'll just use two things which we are hard coding for now. Some dummy values. Let's say its ID is 420 and type is fire, which is obviously wrong. We'll correct that later when we actually dynamically render this code. So we have a container, we have a card. Now already you might be starting to realize that all these divs get very confusing, and putting in native HTML gets pretty confusing. That's why I have to add these comments everywhere. Alright. We have a title bar and we have a very bad looking card. let's make this look a little better. We go to app.css. Now, where is app.css coming from? It is imported from the same directory. So whatever we write in this will get imported in that app.css file. Right, looks slightly better. So this is what we have for the starting. We have, using plain HTML, we have built a simple app. We have the title bar here. We have a simple card here, which has hard-coded values, of course. So I think this was adding HTML content. So basically, we haven't broken down our application into anything. All I took is I just took the basic React application, and I wrote plain HTML in it with some changes because the class name and that name has changed. Some property names have changed, but mostly it's almost pure HTML and CSS. So this is for the people who are familiar with HTML and CSS who want to build React applications. Actually, you can, without knowing anything about React, you can just insert your HTML and CSS code into this and it will work. It won't be very efficient, of course. React has capabilities that you won't be using, but it will work. So this was to demo that.